Today, I want to give you all a tour of the number one resort in Finland, Kakslauttanen Arctic Resort. This resort was established nearly 50 years ago and is famous all across the country of Finland for its sheer size and various different types of accommodations. The resort is so large that it's actually split into two different villages. They have over 220 different rooms. They're currently building a planetarium and they have other unique features like an art gallery and a glass igloo tower. I'm staying in three different accommodations at the resort over the course of three back-to-back-to-back nights. So get ready for some crazy room tours and fun activities. Let's go and check in to our first accommodation. Okay, welcome to the first accommodation, guys. This is the log cabin right here behind me. Before we hop in though, I want to mention, I'll be ranking these three different accommodation types based on three pretty random metrics I came up with on the car ride over here. The first metric being comfortability. How comfortable was it to spend the night here? How big was the bed? How comfortable was it? Did I get a good night's sleep? How much space is there for me to put out my things? Number two is the amenities. Is there something else special here, like a sauna or a kitchenette, something else that made my stay more enjoyable? And last but not least, number three is how unique is this accommodation? Can it be found somewhere else in this world, or is it more of a cookie cutter concept, or is this unique just to this resort, just this location, and you should all be flying across the world to come out and check out this place because it's that unique? So those are the three different metrics, guys. Now let's hop into the log cabin and check it out. Welcome to the log cabin. This is the first in the main room you will see as soon as you enter the premises. This is perhaps my favorite corner in the whole property. There's a little fireplace off to the left, but also almost like a bunk bed setup right here. You can chill here up top. I think it's great for families. And then you can go down here to the rocking chair or another couch off to the side. The cabin comes equipped with a full kitchenette as well and all of your basic tea and coffee. But the amenity that really stood out to me is the Aurora alarm. This thing basically alerts you if you're sleeping. It will go off in the night if the northern lights come out. Now moving into the bedrooms, there are two bedrooms, starting first with this two twin bedroom, and then the master bedroom where I stayed in has this lovely large king size bed. And also the bathroom is right here off to the side, and the bathroom in the main bedroom comes with its own sauna. Another nice little extra feature is it also has its own heated towel racks. Now, rapid fire for those three key metrics. Comfortability, I give this an 8 out of 10, basically just because of the sheer size of this place. It's very massive, two beds, two baths, plenty of space for us. Then for the amenities, I love the Northern Lights alarm, the sauna, the heated towel rack in my bathroom, all the goodies in the kitchenette, the fireplace, tons of fun things here, 7 out of 10. Then for the uniqueness of this accommodation, I give it a 6 out of 10. Again, really cool setup here, but it's definitely not incredibly unique. There's plenty of other log cabin accommodations all over the world. So overall, we're off to a great start, I think, here at the resort. Now we're on to accommodation number two. Okay, guys, welcome to our second accommodation. This is the large glass igloo right here behind me. It is worth noting there are two different types of igloos here at the resort. The large one, like the one behind me, is meant to fit four people. It does have a bathroom, shower, and a few other amenities, but they also have smaller glass igloos meant to fit two people. They're more affordable, but they do not have showers in the igloos. There's a separate building you go to if you're staying in one of those to go shower. This is the main area in the large glass igloo. Again, this igloo is meant to fit four people. So there are four separate beds. Each bed comes with this sort of wacky zebra furnishing, which I thought to be an interesting selection for the area we are in. And each bed as well kind of comes with this, remind me of a hospital bed feature, where you have a little button and you can move the mattress up and down. Also, there's the normal coffee and tea selection. And there is one little bathroom right up here to the side. It's next to the entrance. Pretty basic right here. And then luckily, in case you need to, there is one little shower as well. It gets the job done. Okay, quick review of those three key metrics. For starters, comfortability. Again, you don't come here for a ton of space, you're pure luxury, so there's not a lot of room to move around here. I'd probably give this a 6 for comfortability. In terms of the amenities, again, pretty basic. You got your shower here, you got your bathroom, you got the teas, the coffee. The kind of hospital beds feature was interesting, but I feel unnecessary, so I give that a 6. And last but not least, the unique factor of this igloo. Again, there's plenty of other igloos you've seen in my other videos and around Scandinavia, so this one isn't terribly unique in itself. I'd probably give this a 7 for the unique factor. So let's go head on now to our last accommodation in the resort. This is the third and final type of accommodation, guys. This is the kelo glass igloo right here behind me. It is half igloo, half cabin. So let's go on inside and I'll give you a quick tour. The kelo glass igloo, it has a very similar layout to the log cabin, as you can see right here. The bedding, the fireplace, and the whole couch setup is all basically exactly the same as you can see right here in the kelo glass igloo. They do have another full kitchenette over here though, complete with refrigerator, all the dishes and glasses you can need, and a microwave. I was happy to see our friend the Aurora Alarm made another appearance here in the kelo glass igloo. But now as we move into the bathroom, it's a little more upscale than the log cabin with this red tiling and a sauna here at the end. The main attraction of this cabin though is obviously the igloo to cabin combination, which you can find right here at the end of the main area. It breaks down to the igloo right here. There are these two little twin beds that are perfect for your typical Northern Lights viewing here in Scandinavia. I was chilling out here for quite a bit though during the afternoon. There's actually a lovely view of the nearby river and this cute little bridge. Okay guys, third and final quick review. This is for the kelo glass igloo. So to start with comfortability, I would give this a 7. It's quite similar to the log cabin in terms of space and the comfortability of the beds, the couch, the rocking chair, all that. I give that a 7. For the amenities, again, quite similar. It has the sauna, the Aurora alarm, the kitchenette. So pretty cool amenities, nothing kind of crazy, outlandish, or luxurious. I would give this a 7. And last but not least, the unique factor. I would give this an 8, actually. An 8 for the uniqueness, because it's basically half a log cabin and half of a glass igloo. So he took two very common concepts you have here in Scandinavia, and they mashed them together into one concept right here, which I think is pretty cool. So I'll give this an 8 for the unique factor. So that's gonna wrap it up. I'm curious to hear what you guys think is your favorite of the three different accommodations, but for now we're off to go do some activities here at the resort. Yeah, skiing's definitely not my thing. Never has been, never will be, but it was still a lot of fun to try out some cross-country skiing. After the skiing, we then headed out to the frozen lake with the staff to try out some ice fishing, which I'd definitely never done before. It was really fun hanging out with the media team at the resort. We definitely learned though that you have to be very patient for this activity, and it was very cold out, so honestly we didn't stay out super long. We were told by the staff that sometimes in the warmer months they can stay out for hours on end with some beer and some barbecue and do some fishing, but on that particular day I unfortunately did not catch anything. After the activities, it was time to check out the giant glass igloo tower, which I was really keen to see what was inside. It turned out to be basically a giant mall, I would describe it. Everything from furs to jewelry to shoes to winter gear. There's even an art gallery in the same building just down the hall. I loved walking around and taking in all this different art, and it definitely reminded me of being in the area, all the different blues and whites in the pieces. Now it was time to head to the top of the tower, so I got on the elevator, hit the third floor button, and after going up some winding stairs, I was finally rewarded with this beautiful 360-degree view of the surrounding forest and area right around the resort. Definitely a huge hats off to the resort. I've certainly heard of igloos before, but never a giant glass igloo tower. This is certainly something unique. That is going to do it, guys, from our time here at the most famous resort in Finland. I'm super curious, though. Leave a comment down below what your favorite type of accommodation was of the three that I stayed in. Also, give a thumbs up on the video. It helps a lot. And make sure you are subscribed. Until then, I'll be coming to you next week from so much warmer and much greener pastures. So until then, I will speak to you next week.